Hey, shalom, shalom. Coming at you with another video through the spirit and power of Yahweh, Bahashim Yahushah, Bahashim Rukah Kodash. I want to give the honors to my apostles and elders of Great Millstone who rule well, and grace and peace to you elect around the four winds, believing and pushing this truth in all sincerity. May the blessing of election be upon your houses. This is your fellow servant, Require from the GMS Orlando camp. And coming at you with a quick lesson through the spirit. All right, tonight I want to touch real briefly on finding your balance. All right, finding your balance in this truth. All right, and Lord's witness is edifying and exhorting to you elect Akiman Akwaf out there, because this is something that I'm learning to do myself daily as well. All right, to find that balance, because there are certain routines and certain habits that draw us closer to the spirit, and certain routines and habits that draw us further from the spirit. All right, we want to find and do those habits and routines that draw us closer to Yahweh Hashem Yahushai, especially in the times that we're living in right now. All right. And the inspiration for tonight's video actually comes from something that I noticed in myself, and where in order for my focus to be where it needs to be, I got to put the phone down for a couple of hours, you know, and destabilize my brain. You know, I saw this TED talk where this Edomite was making a couple of good points and how sometimes our brains are overstimulated with the amount of information we consume on a daily basis. You know, we wake up to a screen, we go to work on a screen, we look at our phone screen all day. And that overload of information sometimes makes it hard to focus. You know, so putting the phone down for a couple of hours or a couple of minutes out of the day is beneficial for our spirits, because you got to remember that this 5G that Esau has going on is a spirit blocker, essentially. It's put in place to be a spirit blocker. All right. And when we're on our phone all day, we've got it on us all day. It's around us all day in our pocket. You move from one screen to the next, to the computer screen, and you got the Bluetooth in your ear all day long. You know, that's a low vibration constantly hitting your spirit, you know, and it could be detrimental at some times. So for me personally, you know, putting the phone down for a couple of hours lets my focus get to where it needs to be. You know, for some brothers, going into the diet, cutting out some meats, some heavy meats, is good for boosting energy. You know, myself personally, I noticed that my energy is boosted when I go on a more green diet. You know, not saying vegan or nothing like that, but just a more green diet like Daniel. You know, it helps my energy to be boosted. You know, and things like this, you know, certain things you notice through trial and error, which is important. All right, the scriptures say that a righteous man falls 7 times, but he gets back up again. All right, and the only way that we'll know what's good for our spirit and what's not is through trial and error. It's through the application of this wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. All right, so don't be afraid to fail. All right, don't be afraid to miss the mark on some things. All right, because that's what this grace period is for. All right, that's why Yahweh Shai died, so that we can get back up again. All right, so that we're not condemned with our sins. You know, we have a way back. So don't be afraid to try certain things or to abstain from certain things to see what's good for your spirit and what's not, to find that balance within yourself. All right, because finding that balance is very important. All right, a balance with anything is very important. All right, overdoing or an over surplus of anything is bad. All right, it's bad for you. All right, an over surplus of water, even though water is good for your system, you can drown yourself out. All right. So, you know, an over surplus of anything is bad for you. So you always want to find that balance within yourself. All right. And the Lord is allowing us to find that balance through the application of this wisdom, knowledge, understanding, you know. And I actually heard a TED talk that this Edomite did. I think it was a couple of years ago, going into how sometimes our brains are overstimulated, which Lord's willing, I'll play the clip in this video so you'll see it and hear it for yourself. But, you know, I have a couple of scriptures pulled up. All right. Lord's witness is edifying unto you, elect Akim and Akwaf out there. All right. The point being is to find that balance. All right. Find your balance in this truth. All right. Find what works for you. All right, and what doesn't? All right, this is a part of working out our own salvation. All right, finding what's good for our spirit and finding out what's not. All right, we want to find the things or find a routine that allows us to be closer to Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. All right, especially in the times that we're living in right now. But with that being said, let's hop right into it. All right, let's start off here in Proverbs 20 and verse 23. It reads, "Diverse weights are an abomination unto the Lord, Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, and a false balance is not good." All right, and these diverse weights come in the form of different routines and habits that we have. All right, because certain routines and habits are a weight unto our spirit. All right, and the Lord takes no delight in that unbalance. All right, a false balance is an abomination to the Lord. All right, let's get that in Proverbs 11 and 1. All right, it reads, "A false balance is an abomination to the Lord, Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, but a just weight is his delight." All right, so the Lord takes delight in us finding that balance in our lives and in our spirits. All right, and how do we do that? By proving our own souls. All right, this is Ecclesiastes or Sirach 37 and verse 27. "My son, prove thy soul in thy life, and see what is evil for it, and give not that unto it." All right, and how do we prove our souls? Through trial and error. All right, let's get that real quick, and then we'll jump back. All right, this is Proverbs 24 and verse 16. "For a just man falleth seven times and riseth up again, but the wicked shall fall into mischief." All right, so a just man falleth seven times. All right, a just man, he goes out and he proves himself. He goes out and applies wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. And he may fall. All right, we may fall. All right, we're going to fall. All right, because we're not perfect. We're still in these fleshly bodies. All right, these chains of darkness. So we're going to fail at certain things. All right, we're going to fall. We're going to miss the mark at certain things. But that doesn't mean that we shouldn't try. All right, a just man falleth seven times. But the point being, and riseth up again. All right, he doesn't wallow in his sins. He doesn't wallow in his failures. He improves and builds upon his failures. All right, and he continues to grow, which is exactly what the Lord wants us to do in this time of liberty. All right, in this time of grace, grow through our trial and error, grow through our experience, improve ourselves, improve our souls, and what for what's good for it and what's not. All right, let's hit that back. It's Sirach 37 and 27. "My son, prove thy soul and see what is evil for it, and give not that unto it." All right, and once you see what's evil for your soul, then wisdom will tell you, okay, that's something I don't need to do. All right, if you're a brother that find yourself, you watching TV all day and it's taken away from your time reading, then okay, once you see that, once you realize that that's evil for your soul, then that's something that you probably should refrain from. All right, limit yourself. I'm gonna watch TV for 30 minutes, maybe an hour, then it's going on to the business, you know. That and through things like this, you know, these are small things, you know, and this also applies to bigger things in the spirit, you know. But speaking on the small things, you know, this is how we begin to prove our souls and begin to grow in this truth of ours, you know, by cutting out little things, by realizing certain things that are hindering us, by realizing certain things that draw us closer to the spirit, and giving our souls unto those things that draw us closer, all right, and refraining from those things that draw us further. You know, it says, verse 28, "For all things are not profitable for all men, neither have every soul pleasure in all things." You know, and the next thing, one thing that the next brother is doing may not necessarily be beneficial for your spirit. All right, one brother, he may be able to be on the phone all day, you know, and it still doesn't hinder his focus. But that doesn't necessarily mean that's the same case for you. Another brother may be able to eat whatever, you know, all the. He may be able to indulge, Salaki, stutter. Let me slow down. All right. He may be able to indulge in sweets, you know, and all types of meat, food, you know. But that might not necessarily be beneficial to your spirit, you know, if you get what I'm trying to say. All right. Lord's willing, this is edifying, man. All right. But it says, "Be not insatiable in any dainty thing, nor greedy upon meats. Excess of meats bringeth sickness, and surfeiting will turn into toiler. By surfeiting many have perished, but he that taketh heed prolongeth his life." All right, and this is a part of us working out our own salvation, prolonging our own lives. All right, proving our souls. All right, this is Philippians 2 and verse 12. "Wherefore, my beloved, as ye have always obeyed, not as in my presence only, but now much more in my absence, work out your own salvation with fear and trembling." All right, and this is a part of the process of working out our own salvation, finding that balance. All right, because in finding that balance, our lives are prolonged. All right, in finding that balance, our spirits are drawn closer to Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai and salvation. All right, and that's exactly where we want to find ourselves here in these latter days. All right, so with that being said, that's all I really had to say. All right, Lord's willing, this is edifying and exhorting to you. I'd like to document our quaff out there. All right, to find your balance. All right, and that's only through trial and error. All right, understand we're going to fail. We're going to miss the mark sometimes, but that doesn't mean not to try. All right, that should push you to try harder. Shalom. Stay up.